Hey everyone, and welcome to another daily video from Shopify Dropshipping Lifestyle. My name is Ricky Hayes, and in today's video, we're going into why my Facebook ads die after 2 to 3 days of sales. All right, so let's get straight into it. So this one is just purely an informational video, but it's very important because I do see this question asked a lot in my Gold Class group from people that I'm helping there, as well as in the free group and just in general, which is fine. Why my Facebook ads die every 2 to 3 days? So a lot of people, what will happen, and this happens to me too, is you'll get sales on an ad, you know, let's say you get 2 sales on the first day and you're sort of, yes, this is really looking promising, nothing after the next 2 days, okay? And they're like, oh, you know, it might get better, it might be a bad patch, blah, blah. You can, people even say like, oh yeah, but then my retargeting, but you want to be, the thing is, you want to be profitable on the front end and the back end, okay? At the end of the day, the goal is not to just be profitable on the back end. I mean, that is where you make the real money, but if you can, why not be profitable on the front end too? So you have to be very, I guess, aggressive and conservative at the same time. Now, why this happens a lot is that come a year plus ago, year and a half ago, when Shopify was not dropshipping anyway, and you know, just making Shopify stores because Shopify makes it so easy, was not saturated, then you could, if your ad was doing well, it would do well, and it would do well for a long time, and that was what was the norm back then. What's changed is Shopify has become saturated. A lot more people are using Facebook for their marketing, Instagram for their marketing, and just general businesses jumping on board. You know, times are changing, as well as Facebook have changed their algorithm, okay? So there's been a lot of changes, obviously, over that time. A lot of it's out of our control. We can't control it. Subsequently, what's now happened is that Facebook ads die after 2 to 3 days a lot of the time. I mean, a lot of ads don't. And you have to find those nuggets. Really? Nuggets. Anyway, but a lot of your ads will die. And this is why my strategy is, a lot of people don't understand why I flat duplicate an ad. So that's one of the reasons. So flat duplicating an ad is not changing anything at all. Okay, you change quite literally nothing. There's 2 ways, okay? So you can flat duplicate the ad set and schedule it for midnight on a $5 budget, or you can duplicate it and then you duplicate the actual ad 5 times, okay? Now, because either way sort of works, let's be honest. My reasoning for using the ad set level is that I have one ad in the ad set and it targets those people. Like, it's just... Whereas if you have it in that, if you duplicate an ad, you're going to hit different pockets within that audience again. But I don't know, I just like, I guess, the control, and having it just all in the ad set, one ad per ad set, gives me that more control. Because the thing is, Facebook's very random now. We want to take out as many factors as possible. By having it so that you have an ad set that has multiple ads within it, even if it's the exact same, you're opening up a lot of different possibilities. In that single ad, that can mean the reason why it's profitable or not profitable. Yeah, you can kill off the bad ones, and that's what you'll do. But most of the time, what people do is they'll put $15 on that budget to hit, you know, those pockets. Whereas I just do $15 on 3 different ad sets, and I just know that one ad, because at times as well, duplicated ads as well don't get a new post ID, which means your engagement, because engagement does help, especially as you scale, helps with click-through rates and more engagement, that it's important that you keep that in mind as well. So that's, you can do either way, let's be honest, they're very similar, but I prefer this way. So you just flat duplicate the ad 5 times, 3 to 5 times a minute, depends on your budget and how much you want to scale. And then you use the automated rules. And a lot of people say, oh yeah, but that's such a slow scale. But you got to remember, if you have an ad, let's say you've started with 3 ads and you found only one's doing well, let's say it's 2 sales, you duplicate it 5 times. So all of a sudden you go from 1 to 6, you're spending $30 a day, and then your automated rule, if any of those get any sales and they're profitable with a 2 ROAS, use my automated rule, they'll go to $6, okay? And let's say all 6 of them, then you go, that's $36 a day, and then The next day, it'll be $45 or something a day. And it'll it quickly expands. So by duplicating and adding the exact same form, what you're doing is you're hitting a different pocket, okay? You're hitting... So think of, like, this is why I use large audiences, is narrow audiences used to work, like a 250,000 less used to work, but now it really doesn't because it's just too narrow. You want a larger audience, I find works best. And, you know, you'd say you have a 4 million people audience, you can make 50 ads, 50 ad sets, all on the same budget, hit that 4 million people audience on $5 a day. You know, if you make 40, let's say $45 ad sets, what's that, 200, 4, 5, whatever. My maths is terrible right now. I'm pretty sure that's $200. Yes, it is. So $200 a day of 4 million people, you're not going to burn through that audience. You're not going to burn through that audience overnight. You're going to burn through it over months. And by that time, you're made lookalike. Okay, and that's one way to counteract it. What's going to happen is those five duplicates, probably only two will get sales, maybe three. Who knows? You might get lucky and all of them might get sales, but you'll find that a few of them are not going to get additional sales, and then you just kill them off and you'll scale these other ones. And you do that incrementally, okay? And then over time, then that leads on to the second one, which is then you'll find correlations of that data because now you have the data for where the sales are. You know, I start with age. So you start, well, I mean, if you're, I mainly target women, so... But if you are, whatever, if you got your genders open, you start with gender, then you start with age, okay? And those two optimization methods alone usually allows you to get better ROAS on your ads. And then, you know, if you're targeting multiple countries, which most of you are, then you find country of correlation that's doing well and you split test, okay? And then you duplicate, always on a $5 budget, okay? I just saw someone this morning in my group who is getting some sales, and it's fine to do this, there's nothing wrong with it, but it sort of reiterates, my point, is I see this a lot, is that people are like, oh yeah, I've gotten 2, 3, 4 sales, and then they duplicate it, onto, like, from a $5 budget to $50 budget, and it gets one sale or something, and they've lost that money. Whereas the $5 budget still got one sale, and it's highly profitable, and you think, what the hell? You know, the $50 one had 8 ad to carts, or sorry, 15 ad to carts, let's say, and the $5 one had 2 and it had a sale. This is because this is how Facebook works now. The thing is that I spend thousands of dollars a day on ads, and I have hundreds of ads, and the max that I run on ads now is about $50 on any ad set. I don't really go past that anymore. I just leave it at that because that is my best winning ads. And those, a lot of them are DPA ads because those just get me the most sales. But my point is that low budgets is where it's at now. You go to most YouTube channels and you will see much the same. That's just the reality of it. I don't know why this is a fact. Logically speaking, I have seen people get, you know, 5 sales on an ad set and it's on $5 budget, and you're like, yes, they've already sort of defined the audience. Let's say it's United States, and let's say it's men, and let's say they know it's 35-44. Out of those 5 sales, 4 of them come from that demographic. They duplicate it onto a single ad set at $50 and it gets no sales. Okay, there is no reason why that is. There can be the fact that purely that those people's cards were declined, their phone could have died. There's a million reasons. And that's the thing that I want you all to realize, is that there is so much in marketing that we can do to make more money, but there's so much that we can not do to make any money, like, as well. That you can't control if someone's phone died. That's why retargeting is important. This is why I work on the back end to do all this form of retargeting, you know, in every regard that I really can, that's not too intrusive, to get them back, to remind them. That's why you leave your DPA ads open, because people's phone will die and then they'll be on their computer or tablet and they'll get retargeted, okay? DPA ads work very well for that, and that's why you use all these measures to make it in place. And one of the measures is always just the $5 budget, midnight, duplicating the ad. It sounds so ridiculous, but trust me, It works. You're going to have unprofitable days. You're going to have highly profitable days. This is the way it works now. There's the theories that you go from 1 day to 7 day click. That can somewhat work. There's no real justification around any of this. New ad creatives could work. You know, I've even seen changing the first 5 seconds of the video, changing the thumbnail. These are all things you can do to revitalize an app. However, it really comes down to how much time and effort you're willing to put into this what if. I try and keep it simple and go off, take the creative out of it. The creative comes last because, you know, like if you have one sale and then you try a split test a creative, it's not enough data, you know. You need at least 50 sales before I even try and split test creative, because by that time, I'll have defined an audience more. Like, so because your goal is you make a campaign, you put your ads out, you see what happens, then you narrow down your audience, and then you say to your audience, well, which ad do you prefer more? Which ad do you prefer more? And then, you know, you can be even more specific if you're using stuff like ClickFunnels or Builderall, or there's Page Builder and Zipify Pages, that you can split test the pages and see, well, which, like, you know, do you guys prefer this looking page, this looking page? But those two steps are down the line, okay? First, your goal is you want to get as much ROAS as possible, and that comes from narrowing down your demographic for the most part. Because you can control that, whereas your creative, you know, you can just put it out there and you just go on what if, all right? So I just wanted to make a video just on that today. I hope it has been helpful. Nothing major, but it is a common occurrence that I see a lot of, and I wanted to sort of tackle it and give my justification as to why I use this, because so many people ask me, how does this work for worldwide traffic? It does, okay? How does this work for the big five? It does. At times you just have to, this is a leap of faith. As much as we're an analytically minded group of people that we use analytics to make our decisions, at the same time, there is times where not everything can make decisions, all right? This is why, personally, I'm learning a lot more about Google Analytics, got a lot more reporting doing through there. I've already found a number of optimization strategies and methods that I'm going to test, because the reality is, as well, you should be using Google Analytics to help with that, because Facebook doesn't capture it all the same way Google Analytics does. So that's another expert tip. But anyway, that's pretty much it from today's video. If you did like today's video, hit the like button. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell for daily updates every second day at the moment. If you are new to Shopify, there's a link down below for a 14-day free trial. And there's my group on Facebook, Shopify Dropshipping Lifestyle, okay? Just click, there's a link down below as well. It gives you a free cheat sheet and takes you to my free group. All you have to do is answer a couple of simple questions and you gain access, okay? And for those who really want to get a more one-on-one coaching with me, in my I have my premium group, Shopify Gold Class, on Facebook, where you're going to get that extra bit of support. Well, not extra bit, but a lot more support. I have my lives there. My friends have lives there. There's Q&As. There's case studies. There's so much, and you just, you know, all your questions are pretty much answered in a central place in a very small community, okay? And that's the way, you know, I plan to keep it, and that's why I put a price on it, so that the people in there really put into action this stuff, okay? Not to say everyone in the free groups that aren't anyway, but I have that group because it's, you know, I guess your way of giving back to me as well. So anyway, thank you very much for your time today. You all have a lovely day. Take care and goodbye.